Looks like we got us a little Case S here. Would you consider this a swather or a windrower? Somebody tell me. That Case 400 over there, four bottom plow, looks like a Case. Somebody got a Case 500 over there.
We'll end up with our bundle wagon. See, the engine is actually, once we get the machine set, the engine will be turned around so it will be facing the thrashing machine, and we'll have a belt to stretch from there to the thresher, and then the bundle wagons will come up beside the machine. So our bundle of pitchers will be able to load the machine. We'll have a wind stacker, is what it's called. The big spout that's over top of the machine right now, that will get swung out so it will throw the straw and the chaff away from the machine, and that's just powered by a very large fan in the bottom of the thresher. And the small red spout that's on this side of the machine is the grain spout. The grain will actually come up to the weigher. The weigher is what's on the very top of that elevator. And you can adjust the weights so that every time you have the proper weight of a bushel of grain, it'll open up and dump it into the chute so you can measure the grain as it's being threshed. What we're doing right now is digging a hole. Well, actually, we know what the guys are doing is digging a hole. What we need to do is get, for best operation, is to get the threshing machine level, and level both front and back if possible, but more side to side is more important. And actually, by digging down a little bit and putting the rear wheels in a bit of a hole, that will help hold the machine in place so they can get the belt tight enough to run the machine efficiently. But as with any operation, the more people that watch, the more difficult it becomes. That's the way Murphy works. So once we get the machine set, then we'll have a belting demonstration, and the more people that watch a belting demonstration, the more times it will fall off. So we'll see how well the crew does, and quite often they'll be able to turn around and pull into the machine in a single shot and be perfectly lined up. Of course, the fellow standing on the steam engine right now, Darren, he cheats. He's a surveyor by trade. Justin. Okay, I'm sorry. It's been a long day already. Been talking too much. Yeah, Darren cheats to use Justin because Justin is a surveyor and he's got the surveyor's eye. Because to even accounting for wind, you have to have the machine and the engine lined up so they're pointing at each other and so they are squared to each other. We'll be running a twist in the belt, and the twist we use in the belt is to help the belt run. It'll help the belt stay on a little bit better, and also as the engine is pulling on the belt, you see how close to level they are when they drop her in the hole. We're checking the level now, but with the twist in the belt, as the steam engine is pulling the belt away from the threshing machine, that run of the belt is tightened. And that's where the power is the steam engine is trying to pull that belt away from the thresher. The run of the belt going from the steam engine back to the thresher machine is actually becomes a little bit loose because that belt will stretch. And what we do is we put the tight side of the belt on the downwind side. So if we have a crosswind, we put the tight side of the belt on the downwind side, so the loose side of the belt can just run against the tight side, and it will stay on the machine very nicely.
if you have the loose side of the belt on the downwind side and you have very much wind, the wind can take the belt right off the machine and you have to start your belting all over again. So it's a game of try and experience, and we'll see how well the crew does.
All right, everybody, talk to me. What is the difference between a 600 and a 500? This guy got four weights on it. Looks like pulling the water wagon. Steam engines need water. Nice little setup of combines here.
And one reason we're set up
pick up heads
particular spot right now are the wind is coming from my back or the trailer, which is
case D. I'm gonna have to take a look at that.
Or at least in the slow.
Even a case combine, look at that, nice. Looks like it's gonna be a pretty good show out here. Nancy Harris combine, looks like it's being pulled by a 44. Looks like we got us a Minneapolis combine.
Yeah, there's one that's, yeah.
Open station there.
Pull that little plug, set a plug out. Come on. Good. Maybe she'll run good now.
Yep.
That's awesome. That'll be my first time. I know it didn't run the last 7 years.
Pretty cool. guess while we wait for the separator to get situated, that case combine coming up over the ridge over there. That's pretty cool. Deer or something over there with the plow sunk in the ground. They're gonna talk a little bit. Seeing Oliver over there. Up some bundles out there. Coming across. Looks like it's being pulled by a case DC. Farm OM down there. Oh, DC guy got plugged up. Go to a lot of places and have this much action. Thank you. activity here. Can't get it all in. The deer combine back here. Minneapolis combine's giving her a go. Thank you. quite a bit of plowing done over there. I'm not wasting any time on this side of the field. That's some black soil there. Must be good stuff. about done combining. Even got a green card out there. See the little ants over there starting to plow. It won't take them long. You'll have this whole thing plowed. It's pretty fun to watch. be fun to participate someday. Looks like this WD-45 is about to put one in the ground. Maybe circled around. Yeah. Got her now.
Didn't raise it very high. Pull it out of the ground a little more.
Thank you. I guess you call that a bucket trencher. Got an Alice grader over there. Hey, you suppose we'll get some stack talk out of this Mac coming up the hill? Probably won't sound as good as Detroit. Right there.